Thank you for installing Workast into your Slack workspace. This session will show you the basics of using Workast so you can start managing projects and tasks today. Once Workast is installed into your Slack workspace, full members of your Slack account can access Workast on their own by taking action in the app themselves or by being invited to use Workast. We do not send out any messages or notifications to team members that are not using Workast. To get started, we are going to click on a Slack channel where you would normally give and receive work to your team. Here, I'm in the marketing channel and we're going to create a space by typing /todo and pressing enter. A space is where tasks live in Workast. Tasks created in this Slack channel will automatically show up in this marketing space in our web app. We will go over this later in this session. The next step is to create a task. In the channel, type /todo and then the task. Here, we can assign the task to Sarah and set the due date all at once. Now press enter. Sarah is going to receive a notification in Slack about the task we just assigned her. This is one method of inviting your team member to Workast. I'll show you more ways to invite a team member later in this session. Here, you can see the due date was auto-populated based on what we wrote in the task. Now, Sarah will know that she has to do this task by this date. Another really simple way to create a task is by typing /todo and pressing enter. This form will come up to create a task. By default, the space that is shown here will be the current space in the Slack channel you are currently in. You can change this using the drop-down list, and this will change where the task will be created. Here is where we type the task. This section here is the person that the task will be assigned to. I'm going to assign this to Blake, and he will receive a notification from Workast that he is assigned the task. This is the deadline for the task. Blake will receive a notification from Workast that the task is due. This is a great reminder for your team members so they don't forget what work needs to be done. This section here is extra information you can add into the task that will help assist the person that needs to complete the task. Here, you can see Blake has asked me to review his work. Instead of this message getting lost in the Slack chatter, I can quickly turn this message into a Workast task by clicking here, and then create a task. This converts the Slack message into a Workast task so you don't forget what needs to be done. Now that we've created a few tasks in this marketing channel, there is a quick and easy way to see all the tasks that are pending by simply typing /todo list. This will bring up all the tasks in this marketing channel. From this list, you can take further action on the task. Just click on the ellipsis and it will have a list of actions you can take. You can use this button to complete a task in Workast. It will mark the task as completed in the list and the followers of the task will be notified that the task has been completed. Here, you can edit the task itself, add a description, update the due date and time, or change the person who is assigned to the task. This is a quick and easy way for you to assign this specific task to yourself. The remove button will remove the task from the list. The task is archived and can no longer be found in the list. You can also click on the buttons below the list. This will bring up the new task modal, so you can create a task in the Slack channel. This button here will open this space in the Workast web app in the browser. We'll discuss more about the Workast web app later. When you type /todo list, the list shown here is only shown to you privately. It is not posted in the channel. So with this share button here, you can publicly share the tasks in the channel so that the rest of the team can see what work needs to be done. All notifications for Workast will be received in the Slack direct message with Workast, which is found under Apps on your sidebar in Slack. Here are some examples of the notifications you can receive from Workast. You can customize your notifications in Workast by logging into the Workast web app in the browser. This section here is the Workast home in Slack. You can see up here you have all the buttons to create a task and submit a form. Here is where you can invite your team members to Workast. You can include a custom message and your team members will be sent a notification through Slack. Here, you'll be able to open Workast in the browser. These buttons are also shown when you create a task. And all the Workast tasks are clickable links, which will bring you to the Workast web app. Here we have information about meetings, current tasks, and reports. This part of the session will cover off how to use Workast web app in the browser. In the beginning of this session, we created a Workast space in a Slack channel called Marketing. Here you can see the tasks we created earlier. By default, it has gone into the open task list. This is the default list that all spaces have. To organize your work better, we recommend that you think about the stages of your project or category of work and create lists to break down your work into different sections. For our marketing space, I'm going to create the different categories of work that our team takes care of. So to create a new list, go to the bottom of the space and click on Create a New List. Here, we're going to type blog writing and press Enter. I want to create a few more here, so you can just do so by following the same procedure. From here, you can move tasks into this list or create new tasks in the list by clicking here. As you can see here, this current list view is our default view of Workast. The other views we have here are the board view. Here, you can see the lists as columns. You can move tasks across different lists easily and quickly and see all the completed tasks in the last column here. This is great for those who like to see their tasks visually in cards side by side. The calendar view is great when working with due dates. Here we have a space that has a lot of due dates and you can see all the tasks that are due for this month using the calendar view. Managing tasks in Workast is simple. We'll go through all the details of the task and what you can do so you can start managing tasks today. This here is the task. This is editable by clicking on it and updating the text. Just be sure to press Enter to save any changes. Here, you can see which list the task belongs to. This is the due date and time. Due dates can be recurring. Just click the drop-down menu under Repeat and choose your options. This task is unassigned. But if you click on this icon, you'll have different options to assign the task to your team members or yourself. If the person is not listed in this view here, just search for their name by typing in the search box here. Here is more information about the task. This can be edited. A tag is a way for you to categorize your work. Tags can be used across all spaces. For example, when Blake had asked me to review his work in Slack, I can tag the task with for approval so that I know that this particular task is waiting for my approval. The great thing about tagging is that you can run reports based on this tag and get an overview of all the tasks with this tag to give you greater visibility of what needs to be done. Dependencies show one task is waiting on or dependent on another task. Here we can see this blog article is dependent on this task here, which is the design of the image for the blog article, meaning that the design work needs to be completed before the blog article can be completed. This is a subtask. Subtasks are great when you have a large task that needs to be broken down into smaller tasks. Subtasks can also be assigned to different people within the team and can have its own due date. Files and attachments can be attached to a task. This is useful when sharing information and all files remain on the task. A follower is anyone that is interested in the task. By default, the person that created the task is a follower. Team members that are assigned to the task are followers, as well as anyone who comments on the task. This section shows the activity of the tasks and any comments. You can mention your team members in the comment to send them a notification in Slack about the task. All the history is kept here in the task and shown by clicking here. Last but not least, to complete a task, click on the Mark Complete button. This will complete the task and move it into the completed list you see here. In this section of the space, you can see the participants of the channel. You can add or remove participants here. We follow the same privacy settings that are set up in the Slack channel. Whoever has access to the Slack channel will be able to see the connected space and the task associated. Once you start working on multiple projects and you have tasks in a few different spaces, reports is a great way to get visibility over everything you are working on. Workast provides some standard reports here, but I'll show you how to set up your own report. As we mentioned earlier, tags can be used to categorize work across all different spaces. We previously created the For Approval tag. Now let's create a report that shows us all the tasks across all the different spaces that use the For Approval tag. Next to the reports, click here to create a new report. The default status is pending tasks, which are tasks that have not yet been completed. Now, to run a search using the tag we created earlier, click on the plus to add a new filter and choose tag. Now, click on here and type in for approval. Then click on apply. Here, you can see all the tasks which have been tagged for approval across all the different spaces. To take it one step further, we can also search for the tasks that are due in the next 7 days. So click here, then due, then click on next, and then add 7 days here. This will show all the tasks that are tagged for approval that are due in the next 7 days. This will help us to prioritize and manage the work we need to do for ourselves and for our team. From here, we can complete the task, assign it to ourselves or someone else, or edit the task. You can save this report and it will stay on your sidebar here. The report will run every time you click on it and be updated with all the new tasks that come in. Another way you can use reports is to see all the tasks that your team members are assigned that are overdue. To create this report, click here. Click on the plus and choose Assign To. Then type the team member's name. To add multiple team members, click the plus here and then continue adding the other team members. For the due date, click the plus, then due. Now let's choose the last 7 days, so this will show all the overdue tasks. These results show all the tasks assigned to Angeli, Blake, and Sarah that are overdue. You can see the different spaces they are in and when the task was due. From here, you can follow up on the outstanding tasks. There are endless possibilities and filters to see the information you need. We provide some standard reports here for you, and as you create more tasks in Workast, these reports will help you to get more visibility over what needs to be done. For now, I hope you've found this session useful in getting started with Workast. Thank you.